Hello, my name is Dr. Caroline Dimond and I'm the Director of Public Health for Torbay. I would imagine that many of you will be particularly concerned at the moment, especially if you've been following the national news and have seen the number of cases and hospital admissions going up around the country. I understand also that being now in a national lockdown will be difficult and a very worrying time for some of you, maybe especially if you run a business or work in the hospitality and leisure sector, or if you have school-aged children and are wondering about childcare. Some of you, though, may be more relieved, particularly if you work in the NHS or the care sector, because the lockdown will support you in the work that you do to care for us all when we become sick and frail. What I wanted to do today was to let you know what the position is in Torbay at the moment, summarise some of the changes and let you know where you can go to find out more. As usual, I'll also have some key asks of you. First of all, however, I'd like to thank you all of those of you that have been following the asks that I have had of you in the last few weeks. Your efforts in your communities, neighbourhoods and towns to follow the guidance and keep your overall contacts down over Christmas have, I'm certain, helped keep our rates of COVID lower than some other areas in the country. That effort will really help us all, and particularly will help the NHS over winter as we enter the toughest winter weeks. In the last week, though, inevitably, we're seeing those rates now going up. This will mean that we will still, for a couple of weeks, see more hospital admissions and sadly more deaths from COVID in Torbay. We expect rates to go up in winter, but like everywhere else, we're now probably beginning to see the impacts of the new variant. It's a lot more transmissible. It's easier to pass on. In terms of the numbers, last week we had 166 cases and our rate currently is 121 per 100,000. This is below others in the southwest, but it has gone up by 81% in the last week. The highest rates, like we saw last time, are in those working age adults, especially this time in the 20 to 40 year olds, where the rate currently is 231 per 100,000, a lot higher. So us adults in particular need to be a lot more careful at the moment. So what are the changes in lockdown? These have already outlined in a number of websites and social media accounts, including the Torbay Council website. But essentially, the main message is to stay home wherever possible, except to shop for essentials, food and things like that, if you're undertaking essential work that can't be done at home, and of course, if you need to go out to access healthcare. Schools will be closed to all children, but some children will be still eligible to attend and nurseries will remain open. We'll continue to work really hard with schools and nurseries to ensure it's safe as possible for these children, young people to still attend. And parents and carers will be alerted to the plans in their own local schools. I'd also like to encourage you to consider the following, however. During lockdown, please do look after yourself. You can still exercise within your household or with one other person, particularly if you live alone. See if you can get out and get some fresh air once a day. Also, look out for each other and remember the Torbay helpline is there to support you with whatever needs you've got, whether they be mental health, need for food, or just someone to pop in to get your medicines. Do ask for help if you need it. Also, look out for information, financial support and for businesses on our website at Torbay Council. There are some reasons also to be cheerful at this time. Firstly, as we start the new year, the positive news is that we've now got over 160 people in Torbay signed up to the Champions Network, the COVID Champions. These volunteers are doing brilliant work, keeping themselves and others informed, sharing messages with their families, their friends, their workplaces and their wider communities. There's still an opportunity to sign up for this. You get a newsletter and you can join the online forums. Check out the Torbay Council website if you're interested. Information and helping people understand what is happening is a really powerful tool. Secondly, This winter, we are also helpful because we're starting to roll out the vaccination programme led by the NHS and our primary care colleagues. Many of our most vulnerable residents have now already received the vaccine, which is great news. And we hope that this week, people living in care homes will start to receive theirs. And I'm particularly pleased about this. The new Oxford vaccine is much easier to move about. So it's going to make this vaccination programme easier. Of course, you'll understand that the focus is still on vaccinating those who are most vulnerable, and it will take many months to complete the whole programme. Now, unfortunately, I've got no crystal ball that will tell me what will happen in the weeks and months to come with COVID. But I do know that we do have an opportunity to keep our rates down and prevent the pressure on the NHS. I was particularly moved by the stories from some of the doctors and nurses working in intensive care that I've seen on the news. My thoughts are with the families who have sick relatives and all those frontline staff at the moment. It's really tough for many of you out there. We do, however, live in an area with an incredible community spirit, and we can and we will get through this. We can, together, prevent the steep rises in cases. The lockdown will help us, and you following these simple following asks will also help. There's just four of them. First of all, please stay home wherever possible. This is the most important ask. Secondly, if you do need to go out, please follow the hands, face and space rules. Think COVID. Thirdly, reduce to an absolute minimum your contacts outside of your own household. Don't burst another household bubbles. Remember, at least one in three people with COVID have no symptoms at all, and anyone you meet may have COVID. And fourthly, please self-isolate if you have symptoms and get the track and trace system to upload your close contacts so they can be contacted also. In Torbay, let's work together and let's hope for a hopeful new year. Thank you.